Welcome to Watcher, it's time for another tier list. Don't we all love them? Anyway, thanks a lot for being here. If you're new, be sure to subscribe and leave a like if you enjoy the content. I truly appreciate that. At first, I was thinking about ranking the characters according to their intelligence, but then I was like, nah, maybe another time. My assumptions would probably offend a lot of people. So let's do it another time, when more people are watching. Today, I want to do a list that will make you learn a bit more about me. Quite narcissistic. This will be my most narcissistic list ever. I can't even believe I'm doing this. It will be something like a Q&A, but only with the answers and no questions. You'll have to come up with the questions yourselves. What I'm trying to say is that I'm going to make a list where I rank the characters according to how much I relate to them. In other words, of how much they are like me. I'm not sure this will turn out well, but let's try. The tiers I will include are a tier called Me, for characters who could be a representation of me in the show. And then we have the Relatable tier, for characters who have traits similar to mine. Next up is the Very Little Like Me tier, well, for those characters who have at least one thing in common with me. And lastly, the Nothing Like Me tier. This category is pretty self-explanatory. So let's go. The first character on the list is Sir Alistair. And well, what can I say? The only thing we have in common is that we take our responsibilities seriously. The great difference is how we see the world. Next up is Arya. Just like her, I never forget those who wrong me. But unlike her, I've never been known to seek revenge. I think she's more badass than I ever will be. And much more adventurous. The next character will possibly come as a surprise for most of you. But in a world like the Game of Thrones world, I could see myself enter the game and try to win it, no matter what. I do kinda possess the sneakiness of Baelish. I don't even think that anyone has heard my real voice. Chaos. Yes, I would thrive in it. I think I'm getting a bit too ahead of myself, so let's continue. Although I admire Brienne as a character, there isn't that much we have in common. Only the fact that we want to protect what's dear to us, which I believe most people want. Here comes Bronn. Another epic and fun character. I'm neither a fighter or someone who finds purpose in the enjoyment of life. The only thing I share with Bronn is humor. He's one of the funniest people in the whole show. Next up is Cersei. I tried to find something we have in common, but I simply couldn't. And I don't want to force anything. We are opposites who have lived completely different lives. Another character that I don't have anything in common with is Daario. Not even our taste in people is similar. Well, the only thing that's kinda similar is our names. Alright, here comes an important one. Believe it or not, but I have seen myself in Daenerys a couple of times. I've been an entitled brat. I've had a skewed sense of justice, and I felt invincible because of who I am. Thankfully, all of that got destroyed, because I really needed that to progress in life. Maybe that's why I dislike her so much, because I see a bit of my old self in her. Alright, I'm already feeling disgusted with myself. Such a narcissistic video. Let's keep on going. Then we have great old Davos. Oh, I wish this is who I will become one day. Hearing him speak and act is as if I'm hearing the ideal version of myself speak and act. What a gentleman. If I'm ever lost, I'll just think, what would Davos have done? Ellaria is a character I don't relate to at all. I even fail to see her point of view. For me, she's the epitome of weakness, or rather, helplessness and desperation. Take me out of here quickly. When it comes to Gilly, I really relate to her innocence and naivety. And just like her, I've always stood up for myself, no matter what. Unfortunately, Grey Worm is a character I don't see myself in. He's admirable, but it's difficult to relate to what he's been through. I'm one step away from being the high bird. The only difference between him and me is that I don't see myself as an enforcer of the truth. The truth is something we all have to find for ourselves. No need to force it. If you have questions about the world, ask them, seek the answers. But if you don't, then don't force it. Just live your life. Maybe that isn't your purpose this time around. But just like the high bird, I'm very into that kind of stuff. I began to relate to Jaime when we saw things from his perspective. I'd like to think that I'd do the same in his position. I like that he isn't blindly loyal, and that he has the ability to see beyond himself, which I hope I also have. He's become quite a relatable person, even though he's still very complicated. Jaqen has just taken things a bit too far. I'm also no one. But not to the point of being creepy. For example, when I do these reactions, I need to pick a face and become someone. There is no duality. But to get through this illusion, you sometimes have to enter the game. Jon Snow is a character I can relate to. So far, he's done things I agree with, mostly. The big difference is that he's more serious than I am. A bit of an emo, actually. Once again, here comes a surprise. His name is Jorah, and he is a copy of me when I was 14 and madly in love. I don't want to talk about it. Let's move on. Loras is an interesting one. The most known character we know the least about. He likes dudes. That's all I know. But I like that he's true to himself. Other than that, I guess we're quite different. Like, I'd prefer to see his sister naked. Just saying. And speaking of his sister, here she is. This is me if I was a woman. And if I decided to be sneaky. As is also the case with Baelish. I can relate to her fake smile and her manipulation tactics. Alright then. Next up is Lady Melisandre. And I'm not gonna lie, but I'm also into the Lord of Light. She is the most mysterious person in the show, and I'm greatly into that kind of stuff myself. Missandei is a sweet person. I'd like to think that I can be as well. She's very understanding, and I think very easy to relate to. She's just an overall good person. The Ice King dude is epic. Honestly, isn't he all of us at some point in life? Don't we all just want to see the world freeze? I do. I would have put Lady Olenna as me, but she's simply too intelligent. I can't put myself on the same level as her. She's the perfect version of who I want to be. Let's be honest here. Can we truly be angry at Ollie? He's a traumatized kid that's been led astray by hatred and by people being in his ear with evil thoughts. I feel bad for him, and I can't say that I'd be much different under the exact same circumstances. Anger is difficult to deal with. Especially as a child. Dude, Podrick is so me. I'm just as goofy, clueless, and good with women. I'm just kidding, I was ironic. Still, I am Podrick. This man, Qyburn, was that his name? Is actually very little like me. I'd faint if I did what he did. What we do have in common is our calmness, and maybe our soft voices. I don't know, you decide. Guys, do I have anything in common with Ramsay? I'm pretty sure I don't. The same should be the case when it comes to Roose. But here is Sam. The ultimate me, even more so than Podrick. I love libraries, and I never fit in. And my dream would also be to become a maester. I'm just a tall and slimmer version of Sam, and I wouldn't be able to handle the beating he handled. Oberyn's daughters have been a huge disappointment. They are great fighters though, and I'm not. They're not very bright, and I am. Excuse my arrogance, but in this case, it is the greatest form of humility. Sansa is me with a VJ. Once again, I relate to her innocence and naivety, and how she handles difficulties, and much more. She's been able to stay true to herself, which is a testament to how strong she is. I might be overestimating myself here, but Sansa is a character I aspire to be like. Let's just say that I hope I would have been like her. As I've said many times, Ser Barristan has been a blind follower, a true servant. Personally, I can never be like that. Guys, what am I? According to this list, one would think I'm a girl. Well, who cares? I guess I am. And I'm proud to be one. No, but seriously. Just like Shireen, I love to learn and read and immerse myself in fantasies and stories. It still hurts me that such a bright child had to face such a horrible ending. Stannis and I actually have a lot in common, especially the fact that we're both quite robotic, as if we both have Asperger's or something. The main difference is our ambition though. I'd never go as far as he did. Yeah, the mountain is totally like me. What? Can't you see the similarities? Strange. I don't even know anything about this girl. She hasn't done much. I guess she isn't much like me. Theon is a difficult one. He's much more enduring and patient than I am. And the strange thing is that he's also more impulsive than me. And probably not as sneaky and discreet. When I was younger, I was very much like Tommen. I relied upon others. And people often said that I'm too kind. To think that people can be too kind in an already harsh world. Anyway, I feel for him as a character. Tormund has very little in common with me. I like what he fights for, but his whole personality is so different to mine. He's bold, intimidating, and strong. I don't think I'm any of those. I just agree with his purpose. Tyrion is probably the most difficult one to place here. I'm neither an alcoholic or a little person, but I do agree with what he stands for and how he views the world. He's quite chill and ambitious enough, and I'd like to think that I am as well. Lastly, we have the great Varys, the spider. Just like him, I like to be informed about what's going on. And similar to Baelish, I believe he's sneaky as hell, something I do relate to. He never reveals too much, and prefers to keep important things to himself. I guess that's something we have in common. So that's it, my narcissistic list. I feel disgusted spending so much time on myself. This is the kind of stuff that makes me want to get beat up, preferably by someone attractive. Anyway, now you know a bit more about me, and about how I view the characters, and how I understand them. Who would you say that you're most like? And who are you least like? I'd honestly love to know, like, which characters are the most relatable ones. Anyway guys, thanks for being here. I hope you've enjoyed this, and I'll be back with the next season as usual. So be sure to subscribe for more, and leave a like if you found it enjoyable. I'd truly appreciate that. See you soon, in season 6.